One sheet.
No, I have two copies.
Oh, you, Isabel. Sorry. It's nice to see you, Isabel. Don't steal the music. Right. There we are. Lucy, you can have one because Isabel found us one. Right. Okay. So, here we go. Let's have a little... Sing that. Okay, because the congregation will hear the tune as well, right? La, 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 la. You're like a little oboe on the top. A medieval banquet. Like that. Not bagpipes. Okay, here we go. This is the day. Ready? Ready? One and two. Ah. Right, okay. Now, this is a... Now he's living, page six. Ready, got that? One and two.
Now he is living, the Christ. Out of the tomb he is risen. He has conquered death.
Make it sound musical. That would be fine. Just sit down for a minute. So, in order to survive the service, you need various things. Right. Listen up. Get a pencil. So the first hymn is Christ, Jesus Christ is Risen Today, which you need in your hymn book. Okay. So you find that. So it says number five. Okay. But that's indicating the hymns at the back of this book. Right. So it's number 205. So you take that out. And then we sing, the next thing we sing is the Massive Wine Gloria. Right, do you want to have those? Do you need those? Yes, right. Right, meditate for a minute. Get your music in the right order.
Thank you.
Amen, blah, blah, blah. Right, and then for the Lamb of God, we did the Mass of New Wine again, yeah? Jesus, that bit, yeah? Okay, then at communion there are two hymns. We will do the first hymn first, which is number 3. I'll tell you what hymn comes first, because I go like that. Okay, that's the Lord of the Dark. Yeah, and then we'll do this Joyful Easter Tide, and then we'll do the next hymn, which is number 7. Okay, it's number 7 in your booklet. That's that. And then number 12, that's fine. And then at the end, we do number 12, which is 9 with the glory, which is the death count for. Then we do the Hallelujah Chorus. Okay, so put your hand up and need Hallelujah Chorus. Tuesday, you would need it. You may have a copy of the sign. Have you got a copy of the sign? Somebody on the side. That's that, and then you trot out again. Okay. Any questions? Great, thank you very much. Okay, service starts in 7 minutes. Thank you.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Jesus said the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
So welcome to our service today, to both those in church and those joining us online, on this glorious morning when we celebrate the risen Lord. So let's start with our prayer of preparation. We pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As Christ was raised from the dead, let us receive new life in him as we confess our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with the living bread. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, peace to his people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your
Let us pray. God of glory, by the raising of your Son, you have broken the chains of death. Fill us with faith and hope, for a new day has dawned, and the way to life stands open in our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
with you.
And also with you.
Hear the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went, and they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Speak in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. I'm going to ask any of the young people in our congregation this morning, there are some young folk around, to come out and gather around our lovely Easter garden. So please do come out of your pews, young ones, come and have a look at this beautiful garden. Don't be shy. There are lots of young folk around. Please come down and have a look at the garden. The young people gathered here on Sunday morning. Come right in the front, right in the front, guys, right in the front. They gathered here on Saturday morning to go into the churchyard to scour for all bits and pieces. And they've made a wonderful garden here for us to look at, to enjoy, and also to think about what it's all about. Come right in the front, guys, right in the front there. Right in, have a look. Anyone else want to join us? Now, you'll see in this wonderful garden, it's in two parts, isn't it? We've got what's down that side, folks? What's down over here? The crosses. That's where Jesus was crucified. What's on this side over here? Yeah.
That's the tomb where he was buried.
That's right, where Jesus was buried. Now, the stone isn't rolled away, folks. Well, actually, we're going to roll it away now, aren't we? Let's roll the stone away. And what do we have there? Is there anybody in there? What do you think, guys? Anybody in there? No. The tomb is empty. And this wonderful garden speaks of two things for us this morning, everyone. When I come closer, Benji, have a look, Benji, over here. The wonderful nature of this garden is you've got the crosses on the one side and you've got the tomb on the other side. And what Easter is all about is the difference between the one side and the other side. This side of the cross, as we were reflecting on Friday, was where Jesus was crucified, where terrible things were done to Jesus, wasn't he? He was nailed to a cross. He died there. People did terrible things to other people. And on this side of the garden is a kind of an image of our world today. We can think of Haiti, we can think of Ukraine, the Middle East, Rafa, all these places today, which is very much on this side of the garden. A place of suffering, a place of darkness, if you like. If you think about it, girls and boys, when Jesus died, what did the disciples do? Yeah, what do you think they did?
They say they had nothing to do with Jesus.
Well, that's what Peter said before Jesus was crucified. He said he didn't know him. He actually denied that he knew Jesus at all. But most of the disciples, when Jesus was arrested, what did they do? Did they go with Jesus, or what else did they do? Yes. They fled, they ran away. As we heard, even with Mary this morning, the gospel, they were terrified when they found the tomb empty. People were very scared, terrified, because when you see someone dead on a cross, the Romans were very good at putting people to death in a very horrible kind of way. This was the worst kind of death you could have. Jesus died there, and they saw it. And when you see someone dead, you tend to be dead. That's it. You're not coming back to life, isn't it? And this is what they saw. A picture of death and darkness. No hope at all. No life at all. And they fled. Mary and John, of course, did stay. They were at the foot of the cross. They were there to the very end. They also thought, that's the end of the story. Now, is it the end of the story? No. Because on the other side of the garden, and this is what Easter is all about today, we live in a world full of darkness, and we don't have to think very hard of those images in our minds and hearts of what the world is really like today. It's a terrible place in some parts of the world today, and we are desperately need light and hope. Well, Jesus today gives us that light, that hope, that new life. Because on that side of the garden, where everyone thought, like Mary did, when the two Marys who went to the tomb early in the morning, they thought they'd find the body of Jesus there. And it wasn't there, was it? It was empty. And the angel said to them, "He is risen. He's not here anymore. He's risen to new life." And so that side of the garden, that's why we have all these flowers here of spring and new life. Jesus says to each one of us that we can share in this new life. The world doesn't have to be on this side, the crosses, death, darkness. What Jesus is saying to us all today is that our lives are meant to be about life, new life, hopefulness. Because this death bit at the side of the garden is not the last word. Isn't that right? The story did not end when Jesus died. It's a wonderful new beginning. And Easter is a hopeful message to all of us. One thing I want to say to everybody, you know, when you think of Easter Day of joy, and of course it is, new life, of course it is. What we need to think about is when Jesus met his disciples, he had his wounds on his body. He had been through death. And that part of his was part of who he was. He was like us, a human being, but he had the wounds of his suffering. Sometimes we think of Easter and we don't think much of Good Friday, but they go together. Jesus is like us. He suffers, and he suffers with all of us too, because we're not perfect. We know what's going on in parts of the world that are just horrendous right now. He suffers with us even now. But the good news is, he suffered and he carries those wounds, but they are wounds for our healing, wounds for our new life that we can have in him. So Jesus is saying to all of us today, on this Easter day, put your trust in me. I have suffered, I have died, but I have risen to new life. And that's what this wonderful garden's all about. I'm going to invite the congregation to over coffee and tea afterwards to come have a look at this beautiful garden, because it tells us a wonderful, simple story, what Easter is all about. Sometimes we live too much in the dark on those crosses. Our lives are full of maybe too much about the suffering. We should raise our eyes to the empty tomb on the other side. And there's a little pathway here between the two, and that's the pathway we should take, following away from the death and darkness of the cross to the new life and hope of the resurrection in the empty tomb. So do come have a look after the service with your coffee and tea to look at this beautiful garden, and we can all learn so much from it. So that's the message this morning, a very simple one. Live in the light, the truth of God's love, the new life he gives to all of us today that we rejoice in. Alleluia. Thank you for coming up. We'll go back to our seats now. Let's continue with our service this morning. Lovely. Thank you.
So So if you wish to stand, I invite you to do so as we declare our faith in God on the words on page 6. And we'll say all of these words together. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with the power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So please sit or kneel as we bring our prayers before the Lord.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. Faithful God, we think of your church today, celebrating the resurrection all over the world. Language, race, and nationalities may be different, but our worship and our joy on the day of resurrection make us one in the gospel. We pray that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen us in mission and service, praying that day by day we may grow in love for you and for our brothers and sisters in Christ. Lord, we pray for the church in the province of the West Indies, led by Archbishop and Primate Howard Gregory, and locally we pray for the leaders and congregation of the River of Life Church. In the Bristol Diocese, we pray for the work of the diocesan governance and property teams. We ask for your blessing on the DAC and all who work to provide support to PCCs, enabling them to maintain and improve church buildings. We also ask for your blessing on the safeguarding team and in our parish for the work done by Claire, supported by Jill. Strengthen Viv and Neil, our bishops, and all your church in the service of Christ, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, we pray for those who fear for tomorrow. Be close to them and help them to know that they are not forgotten. Lord, on this special day, we pray for peace in the world, and especially we hold before you the situation in Gaza and the Ukraine, and pray that a lasting ceasefire can be found, and anyone being held hostages will be returned to their families. And Lord, we ask for your blessing on the work of Tear Fund, and for its Lent appeal to raise money to equip churches around the world to transform their communities and lift themselves out of poverty. Lord, we pray for King Charles and for Catherine, the Princess of Wales, as they recover from cancer, and ask for your blessing on Queen Camilla, Prince William, and other members of the royal family. Give wisdom to all in authority, and direct this and every nation in the ways of justice and of peace, that all may honour one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for our local community here in Westbury and ask you to be with all those who work in the village, our shopkeepers, hospitality staff, and those who keep the streets clean and well lit. We remember our church school and pray for the staff and pupils and governors and all who work to make it such a successful school. We remember the elderly in our parish, those who are housebound, and those who live in the nursing homes around the village. And Lord, we ask that you will be with all those who are caring for the sick and the disabled and frail. May they feel something of your presence at the times when they are feeling low and are in need of some support and encouragement. Lord, in your mercy, comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Father, we remember those for whom we've been asked to pray for today. Jeff Evans, priest. Sue Evans, Pat Denning, Sally Price, James McGuire, Miles, Michael Borrow, Beverly Willits, Dorothy Chadburn, Kathleen Simmons, Jill Purnell, Jane Keary, Stephen Heath, Tina Ayres-Hunt, Nigel Ratcliffe, David Speller, Noah Bingham, Wade Stevenson, and Jill. And we remember those who have been unwell for some time and are in need of our support and prayers. Paul and Sylvia Townsend, Selena Must Have a Melania, Alan and Yvonne Simons, Lorraine, Susan Davis Jenkins, June Hall, and William. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ. Lord, you are our strength and comfort in times of trouble and tragedy. Be with those who lost their lives this week when the Baltimore's Francis Scott Bridge collapsed, and comfort those who mourn their loss. And in a moment of silence, let us remember all those who we have loved and see no more. And Father, we remember those who have passed into your loving arms in recent days. John Cunningham, Madeline Cunningham, Phil Ragg, Judy Cross, and John Reed. And we remember those whose anniversaries of death fall at this time. Martin Wilkinson, Judy Wilkinson, Robert Roberts, Sue Champion, Alexandra Wardrop, Stella George, Richard Bowden, and Harold Brown. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord.
And let light perpetual shine upon them.
According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I publish the banns of marriage between Andrew Carl Wakeley of this parish and Emily Louise Aung, also of this parish. This is now for the first time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why these persons may not marry each other, you are to declare it now. Just a couple of notices. First, really, to say a big thank you, really, to all those who've spent wonderful times yesterday doing all the flower arranging, the beautiful work all around the church to make our lovely church look so wonderful today. Thank you to them. Big thank you to Claire Waggett too for all the wonderful work we did on Friday with the young people. We're heaving with young kids and families with craft and wonderful work on Good Friday morning. So thank you to her and all those who are helping her too. Wonderful over these last few days of looking forward to Easter today. Just to say that there is a 12:15 Eucharist this afternoon. There's also a court appeal being rung today at 5:30, in honour, of course, of Easter. Tonight we have solemn evensong at 6:30 p.m. and next Sunday a 6:30 p.m. simple evensong. Just to say, tomorrow, of course, is a bank holiday. There'll be no Eucharist here tomorrow as we normally would have. Church will be open, but no worship as such in the church. Parish office will be closed until Thursday, the 4th of April, for those who would like to use it. And lastly, space to grieve, an opportunity for anyone who's grieving, anyone suffering loss, to gather this coming Wednesday, the 3rd of April, 2:00 to 3:30 here in church. Join us for some tea cake and some fellowship and support. Bring those who you know who need some support. It's a lovely opportunity to be used by anyone who is in need of support. I invite you now, please, to stand for the peace.
The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they were glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
So our next hymn is number 10 in our booklets. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. You bring forth bread from the earth. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. You create the fruit of the vine. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks.
Lord of all life, you created the universe where all living things reflect your glory. You give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and to cherish. And now we thank you on this Easter day that through Jesus you have given us new life and saved us from sin and death. You made us all each wonderfully different to join with angels and sing your praise. We thank you, loving Father, because when we turned away, you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my blood, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins."
Jesus Christ has died. Jesus Christ has died. Jesus Christ has risen.
Jesus Christ has risen.
Jesus Christ will come again.
Jesus Christ will come again.
So, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. Help us, Father, to love one another as we look forward to that day when suffering is ended and all creation is gathered in your loving arms. And now, with all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ in the strength of the Spirit, today and forever. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Thank you. So let us pray. God of life, who gave your only Son to die on the cross, and by his glorious resurrection has saved us from the power of death, help us to leave sin behind, that we may live with him in the joy of his risen life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Oh, yeah.
So let us bow our heads to receive God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God the Father, by whose glory Christ was raised from the dead, strengthen you to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you, those that you love and pray for, now and always. Amen. Amen.
He is not here. He is risen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.